वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल PMM क्लासेस। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द फूड पॉइजनिंग। फूड पॉइजनिंग इज एन इलनेस कॉज्ड बाय ईटिंग कंटामिनेटेड फूड और वाटर। दैट मीन्स एनी हाउ व्हेन कंटामिनेटेड फूड एंटर इनटू आवर बॉडी वी एक्सपीरियंस फूड पॉइजनिंग। कंटामिनेटेड एंड अनहाइजेनिक फूड मेक्स अस इल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल जंक फूड और रेडी फूड दैट वी लव टू ईट, इफ दे आर कंटामिनेटेड एनी हाउ विद इन सेवरल आवर्स ऑफ ईटिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ फूड affects our stomach. Symptoms of food poisoning. Most common symptoms of food poisoning are vomiting, nausea, severe pain in the abdominal region, diarrhea. In severe cases, there may be weakness, fever, and damage of nervous system. Cause of food poisoning. These type of symptoms arise due to the presence of toxic organism or microbes such as bacteria, microbes. Some bacteria like Clostridium, Staphylococci and fungi like Aspergillus cause food poisoning. Prevention of food poisoning. Prevention is better than cure. So we can prevent ourselves from such bacteria by some good habits. Food must be prepared properly and stored it properly. That is, those who prepare or handle food should be washed their hands to prevent contamination of food. Number two, by keeping the excess food into refrigerator. Number three, most causes of food poisoning go away in 2 or 3 days. We must always wash our hands before eating or taking our food. So students, always try to eat hygienic and healthy food so that we can save ourselves from this type of bacteria. So students, we have to preserve our food from spoilage and from growth of bacteria, fungi and the microorganisms, as well as retarding the oxidation of fats which cause rancidity. What is rancidity? Now, rancidity means having disagreeable odor or taste due to decomposition of oils and fats. How preserve our food? We can preserve our food by the process preservation. Now, what is preservation? Food preservation is a process of treating and handling food to stop or greatly slow down spoilage caused microorganism. Some methods of food preservation. Number one, drying, using sugar and salt, using acetic acid, using chemical preservatives, heat and cold treatments, pasteurization, vacuum packing, canning and freezing. Now about drying. Drying is the process by which reduce water content sufficiently to prevent and delay bacterial growth. Drying also reduces weight, making food for portable. Some common foods that preserved by drying are apples, pears, bananas, mangoes, papaya, apricot and coconut. Drying is also the normal means of preservation for cereals such as wheat, maize, oats, barley, rice, millet and rye also. Preservation using sugar and salt. Sugar and salt reduce the water content and make it unavailable for the growth of microorganisms. As a result, the food is preserved. Meat and fish are covered with salt to preserve it for a long time. Preservation using acetic acid. Acetic acid in the form of vinegar is used in the manufacture of several pickled products. Vinegar also stops the growth of microorganisms. Citric acid and phosphoric acid are added to carbonated beverages and fruit drinks for both flavoring and preservation. Preservation using chemical preservatives. Chemical preservatives like sodium benzoate and potassium metabisulfite, the KMS, are used to preserve jams, jellies and pickles. These chemicals inhibit the growth of microorganisms. Now about heat and cold treatment. Food items like milk are usually boiled before they are used or stored. Boiling kills many microorganisms present in it. Pasteurization. It is a pressurized heating for a short time. It is considered as a mild form of heat treatment. The temperature used during pasteurization is below 212 degree Fahrenheit or 100 degree centigrade. Milk is pasteurized to destroy microorganisms, but many more heat resistant organisms are only reduced in number, so that pasteurized milk must generally be stored under refrigeration to keep bacterial growth in check. In addition to destroying some microorganisms, pasteurization also inactivates some enzymes also. Now about vacuum packing. Vacuum packing is a process in which food stores in a vacuum environment, usually in an airtight bag or bottles. The vacuum environment strips bacteria of oxygen needed for survival and slow spoiling. Vacuum packing needed for basically nuts to reduce loss of flavor and oxidation. Now about canning. It involves cooking food, sealing it in sterilized jar or cans, and boiling the containers to kill or weaken any remaining bacteria as from or sterilization. However, food preserved by canning or bottling in a immediate risk of spoilage once the can or bottle has been opened. Now about freezing. When foods are kept at temperature below freezing, most chemical changes take place at such a reduced rate that only minor changes are noticeable even after long period of storage. But microorganisms are more resistant to cold than to heat, and although some are killed by freezing, most bacterial spores and a large number of organisms survive in fridge.